So, Tom, thank you so much for being with us today and giving us this interview. I've heard you play at the Orwell Hotel. You're like Felixstowe's famous pianist. No, it's really, I hear such great things about you. So,
thank you.
We met at the Orwell Hotel.
Yes.
Where I heard you play one Saturday evening. Phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal.
Thank you.
So, here we are today, and just want to get to know a bit about the Tom Metcalf.
Yeah.
So tell us, Tom, how did you first sort of start into playing piano?
Well, I grew up in Coventry, mm-hmm. and my dad played in a pub just outside of Coventry. It was just him on the guitar, and this other bloke, Mike, on piano and keyboards. And I'd have only been about 5 or 6 at the time. And for their last gig, my dad said to my mum to take me and my brother to go see him. Mm-hmm. So. Yeah, it was great. I thought it was great being in the pub at that age. But they played away, and this guy Mike on the synthesizer and the piano just absolutely blew me away. You know, the 5. And so going home for the next week or two, I was mummy, daddy, I want a synthesizer, I want to play like Mike. And they were like, well, because kids change their mind every 5 minutes. They were, well, we'll see how, if you still want to do it in a couple of years. So I was like, okay, fine. And then 2 years later, I was still saying, mummy, daddy, I want to synthesizer, I want to play like Mike. Mm-hmm. And we had a piano at home. So I said, well, we're starting on the piano, so you learn the piano before you do all these fantastic things with a synthesizer. Mm-hmm. And I've got a synthesizer, I've got an electric piano sort of thing, but I just love doing the piano. Mm-hmm. And so when I was about 8, they got a private tutor in to come to my house. I was able to start practicing and playing then, so that's how it started.
So did you, at school, did you also take music at school?
I didn't take it, I did it for a few years as it was part of the curriculum.
Yeah.
But I never followed on with it because my private lessons had taken me beyond what they were teaching, so I was bored. And I should have really done it and explored that, maybe got a GCSE, maybe done it A-level, whatever, and gone down that route. But. Yeah. The lessons just weren't doing it for me, so I didn't pursue it.
So do you actually have qualifications, or like very self-taught with along with your tutor?
With the teacher at home, you would go through certain grades, all your classical stuff, you've got your 8 basic grades.
Yeah.
And so I went through and did all that.
Okay. Great.
So, yeah.
Great, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
And so, like genre-wise, did you learn everything, or?
A smattering, after about grade 5 or 6, my teacher started to introduce me to other things, a bit of jazz, popular, show tunes, just to get a broad spectrum of playing rather than just learning the classics. So obviously, I had to do the classics for the grades.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, just so I had an idea, and it wasn't all this, it's classical. It was a lot more called explore and stuff, so I was grateful he did that.
Oh, that's so nice.
Yeah.
And was there a genre that you particularly liked playing?
It does depend what mood I'm in. I do lean towards the popular stuff a lot.
I do.
Because this is what I've done and what I've grown up and listened to.
Yeah.
But, you know, I do like to touch on jazz or blues or whatever, you know, just whatever I'm doing. And sometimes I'm practicing new stuff and I'll do something wrong, but it actually sounds all right, not for that particular song that I'm doing, but that would take me off doing something else and I can go into a different genre or just a different song, or you know, just explore where that's taken me. So yeah, popular, but I do enjoy doing the other stuff, and sometimes it just creeps up on you.
That sounds lovely.
Yeah.
So you're going to play us a bit of music. Right. So talking about the genres, you mentioned jazz. Could you do something a little jazz?
Do a bit of summertime, like the old standard.
Oh yeah,
song.
Okay.
Just a little bit of that, be a couple of verses or something.
Thank you.
I like to think so, but I don't know.
Bless you. That's so lovely. So when you play, do you get a lot of people that say they sort of like go through certain emotions or feel a certain way. Do you get any of that?
Yeah. It's like, different songs can mean different things, and it's nice for me to be able to express that. It's nice as well when it connects with other people.
Yeah.
When people come to me and they'll say, I had a lovely night, really enjoyed listening to you, but that song in particular really was something that I really enjoyed, I've always liked it, or whatever, that kind of thing. So getting that connection with people, that's really good, as well as my release, whether I'm playing in front of people or just at home on my own. It's nice to have that as well. So
that's so wonderful. We obviously took that video of you on Saturday night when I met you, and I've had a lot of people come up to me and say how much they enjoy listening to you, and just the quality of how you play and stuff. It just really brings another atmosphere to the room. So it's well done.
Thank you. It can, especially when it's full in the restaurant, it can really crack all the atmosphere. It's really good. Also, here in the library, it's slightly smaller, and you just get a different mood, different feel.
Yeah.
If there's a function on here, whatever it is, whether it's just a small wedding or birthday, whatever, people just like it. It can really, add to their experience, basically, at the hotel.
Wow, that's awesome. And talking of weddings and stuff, you're available for weddings?
Yeah, I do weddings, birthdays, anniversaries, whatever. Brilliant. Doesn't bother me if they want a pianist, then I'll try and get there if I can.
Do you play with other musicians?
No, I've never done that.
Wonderful. No. Sometimes I think it's even better, because as an audience member, you have to really focus on what it is that you're doing with your instrument. And it's very peaceful. Actually, occasionally get quite emotional with it, actually, as an audience member. It's really lovely.
Well, that's lovely for me to hear. I think I'm doing something right then, it's nice, and that's the idea of it. Everybody has a song or a piece of music, whatever, that they connect with in some way, whether they make them cry, whether they get elated or whatever, everybody has that. And if I can give that to them in some way, then brilliant.
So
it makes it worthwhile.
Yeah,
so not just for my own face that makes it worthwhile.
Absolutely. In fact, there's a piece that you've composed yourself that I just love. Would you play it?
Yeah, of course I will.
Sorry,
I'll
let you drink
that. It's a bit odd. Try not to get that on camera. So.
Especially when you play your own self, God, it really, like, for me, it tells like a bit of a story. I don't know if you have a little story behind your work.
No, I mean, like I said before, you know, sometimes you just hit something and then you go with it. Mm. Other times, you know, I'll be playing with chords and structures of chords, and again, depending on what mood I'm in, what I'm feeling at the time, then go with that. So that's kind of where that comes from.
So with your own compositions, is there anything that you have, like, do you have a goal in your mind of where you'd like to go with your own music?
What I want to do is I think it's something I need to get it recorded. and it's always there then, you know, because I can read music, but I don't write it. I know the thing is, if I'm at home or playing whatever and I go off on something, I want to stay with it.
Right.
So I've got to keep it in my head, and once it's there, it's there.
Mm.
Rather than stop and go, oh yeah, write that down.
Okay,
so yeah. I don't want to lose the moment or the feeling of what I'm doing. So I need to actually just get it recorded,
mm.
record stuff, and not just my stuff, but what I do with cover version and stuff like that. Mm. That'd be good to do.
Wonderful. Speaking of covers,
all right, yeah.
I heard you do a great Elton John.
I try.
No, it's you played a little bit for us earlier.
Right.
Do you want me to do that for us?
Yeah, I'll do that for you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Herself when she's performing, she plays beautifully, sings beautifully. I think she's something special. So I'd like to do a couple of hers. Also 90s when I was 18 to 25, you know, there was your Britpop stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So that kind of thing takes me back to when I was younger. That's nice. So yeah, it's a bit of all sorts, but yeah, whenever I'm feeling at the time. So but yeah, there's some that I'd regularly.
Lovely. You're saying about Alicia Keys, how she seems so alive when she plays. You seem very alive when you play.
Thank you.
So yeah, lovely. I think that's something that's really lovely. You know, when you get a real professional and they're really into their craft, and when you watch, I personally find it really fascinating watching them.
Yeah.
Because they look so into it and focused and alive, just like you're saying.
There is that, and that's why we do it. But at the same time, if I'm not into it, anything like that, how can I expect anybody else to be?
Right. That's a good point.
So yeah, if it doesn't matter, they're going to be like, well, who's this idiot? You know, but it is though, isn't it? It's, you know, you have to put that in and give that to people, and then they do what they want with it. They might not like it or whatever, but you can connect with people that way, and it's the only way you can do it. So you have to be like that.
And being able to play in such a venue like your hotel, you've got these gorgeous spaces, you've got a live piano and then you open the restaurant. You must be able to, that connection, you must have had many people come up to you.
I've had someone, it is, it's lovely. I mean, I'm lucky being here because they look after the piano so well.
Yeah.
They are, they're really good pianos, they maintain them well, they're regularly tuned. Yeah, the atmosphere in the rooms, you know, nice setting like this, and it all adds to it. So I am lucky with that. So thank the hotel for that, they keep it good. No, because you go to other places and there might be a piano that hasn't been touched in 5 or 10 years, and it's out of tune. Some of the notes don't work. It's half in pieces, you know, and it's a shame for a pianist to see that. And you can't use it. You know, so it's just a shame, really. I mean, for my own, for playing for functions, whatever, they don't have a piano, I do have my own digital piano, and I'll be fine, so I can go and do that. You can't be playing the real thing.
Yeah.
So I'm looking, I've got these good pianos here.
That's really great. That's fantastic. I'm always curious to know the creators, because they get a lot of, maybe a bit of stick or whatever, because like you've got, you know, a lot of people might have their opinion on job or whatever.
Yeah.
How do you approach your sort of your craft and your profession when it comes to, like, you know, living your dream of playing the piano and performing for others, and then, you know, because you're a father as well, and taking your kids and stuff. How do you juggle everything and make it all happen?
It's hard, but I wouldn't have it any other way. You know, I've got a regular job here at the hotel. I do the music at the weekends. I've got my family life. And it's all hard and a lot of time, but I love doing all of it. So, you know, if you said take all of them out, I'd be like, well, no, I don't. Although it is, you know, you've got to put the hours in.
Mm.
You know, I'll finish my job here, then I'll go be with the kids, you know, help my wife Claire, raise them, you know, knee deep in nappies and all the rest of it, you know. And then the kids go to bed and I'm able to play for a bit and practice.
Yeah.
So, I don't. That much downtime, but it's great. I love all aspects of my life, so yeah, again, I'm just lucky at the minute, I guess.
Oh, it's so nice, it's lovely. Is your family musical?
My dad, I get it from my dad,
yeah.
But going back, my nan used to sing, as regards my family, Caris, she's one, she will just jig about on the floor.
Your daughter, right?
My daughter, yeah. She's one, so she's not walking yet. But if any song comes on the telly, she's there bouncing around to it, so it's great. My 3-year-old Tommy, he's more of a percussionist, so he will just shake the maracas or bash in as loud as he can. But he will, the few times, so they're normally in bed when I'm practicing, I've got to put my headphones on. But sometimes I will play in front of them, and they are responsive to me, and I'll sit on my knee. And he will, especially Caris, because she's too young, but he will try and play with his fingers rather than hit the keys as hard as he can. But he'll start off like that, and I'll say, no, I'll talk about this, and then he'll start trying to play each note individually. So, yeah, it does get through at an early age.
That's wonderful.
And there's a thing as well that I remember just talking to you. Apparently, when I was still in a pram, if my dad played Summertime, he could play anything, fine. He played Summertime, and key, you'd have to change or start crying.
Really?
Yeah, and you'd have to play something happy and just shut me up.
Really?
Yeah, it just got to me with that age, yeah, when I'd be like, 6 months a year.
That's phenomenal. Yeah. Isn't that funny? There's a, on YouTube, and these cute little clips of kids and babies like responding really emotionally to their mother's singing or something.
Yeah.
That's really cute.
Yeah. Well, I do believe there's that connection there through music to small people, and yeah, it does, I guess, to anybody, any age.
It does, yeah. Definitely. And so you mentioned, was it Mike?
Yeah, I played with my dad.
Really,
yeah.
Really inspired you and everything.
Yeah. Where he played.
Well, I'd love to hear that song that you said he composed.
Yeah. I'll give it a go. Yeah, I can do it justice because it is a beautiful piece.
Okay, super.
Thank you.
That is absolutely stunning. Has he heard you play that before?
No.
No? Oh God, I think he'd love that.
I'd say.
I think he really would. It's stunning, absolutely stunning. So listen, Tom, thank you so much for
being with us tonight.
It was really great. It was so nice to get to know you.
Thank you.
And I hope more people come to Orwell Hotel to come and see you play.
Yeah, that'd be good. Yeah, thank you for that.
You're very welcome.